Welcome to The Pilates Show, where we explore Pilates tips and techniques to help deepen the skill level of the movement educator while having fun.
Hi, Jen and Amelia here again, and we previously did the forward leaning inversion off the reformer to unwind and lengthen the ligaments that attach into the sacrum from the uterus and the cervix, and to also open, create more space in that lower uterus. And I wanted to address that the down dog is a different type of inversion. It doesn't do the same thing, although it's beneficial if the pregnant woman is comfortable doing it. So Amelia's gonna come up onto all fours and she's just gonna demonstrate a down dog. It's always nice to go into gentle inversions, right? This is wonderful. It's taking the diaphragm off the pelvic organs. It's decompressing the pelvic floor. It's helping to lengthen the hamstrings and helping to balance the tissue of the pelvis. But it's not doing what that forward leaning inversion is doing, which is really unwinding those very strong ligaments of the uterus that attach back into the sacrum. So you can come on down. So another thing that we can do when we do the forward leaning inversion to help balance and kind of hold the benefits that we've just gotten from that forward leaning inversion is this next piece that looks very weird. We have the sitting box, we have the Bosu, and we have this airplane pillow that I've been using in the studio that I love to really track and trace the bottom portion of the pelvis. So Amelia is gonna carefully stand up facing the scarf, and she's gonna sit on this very strange contraption. And this is nice because you have the Bosu, which is soft. You have the airplane pillow, which is soft, that has a hole in the middle. So her pelvis, her pelvic bones, including her sacrum, are very, very free here. This is also lifted up. It could be lifted a little bit higher to create more space here. We're going to see another position that is like this, using the end of the Cadillac and the floor, which is going to actually create more space in the front of the hip. But this is good for right now, but this does bring her into a deeper squat. So she's going to climb up on the scarf, and her long back is going to go into a diagonal. So she's pulling down on the scarf, and she is really taking the weight of her torso off her pelvis. She can lift her toes, really dome into her feet. And the first thing that I want her to do is reach into her feet and legs and just lighten the touch of her sitting bone from the airplane pillow. And as she does that, because the airplane pillow is foam, it lifts to meet her. Amelia had me recognize the benefit of that last time she did it. And then she can bring her bottom all the way back down, and so the foam gets a little squished again. She'll do that again. She'll draw and dome into her feet, hug into her pelvis. As she floats and lightens her sitting bones, I still want her to think about breathing into the back of her pelvic floor. So can you unleash the tail and feel like your sitting bones are trying to swipe to the back? Good. And then she can slowly lower back down onto the foam. We're gonna do that one more time. So she's gonna dome her feet, reach into the feet, legs and hips, and kind of swipe the sitting bone and tail back and up. And then I want her to hold this lightness and have the thought that she's really hanging the tissue from the bottom of her rib cage, and maybe that'll cause her to wiggle the pelvis a little bit to really drape and hang. And then when she's ready, she can come all the way down. Now this next technique, she's gonna stay heavier on the foam, but she's gonna start to do a circle around the bottom of her pelvis into the foam airplane pillow. So she can climb up a bit on the scarf. She may not go as high as she just did, but she's still pulling the scarf down into her, and then she's gonna start to go to the pubic bone, to one sitting bone, to the tailbone, and to the opposite sitting bone. So I don't know if you can see this with the camera angle. Keep going. So she's slowly tracing. And I really like this moment where the pelvis gets a side bend and she really gets to drop the hip. And then she comes around and she drops the hip and all the way around to the pubic bone. And then she can change directions. So this is really going to help to mobilize the pelvis and sacrum, the ilium and the sacrum. And the side bending of the lumbar spine and the hip drop and the hip hike is going to be really beneficial in pregnancy to kind of prime the pelvis and the sacrum for some of the things that it might be capable of doing during labor, which are going to be really beneficial. All right, and Amelia can keep going. It feels so good. Thank you for joining us.
That's it for today. If you have a different take on today's subject or if there's anything you'd like to see covered in an upcoming episode, we'd love to hear from you. Comment below on Facebook, Twitter, or in the forum at fusionpilatesedu.com. See you next time and never stop learning.